is there a ratio between alpha and beta? Can you tell on average how much is alpha and how much is beta in hedge fund returns?
When I started coming out with the hedge fund return hypothesis back in 2003, when I first started talking about this, without even having really developed alternative beta strategies model, I was basically saying it's an 80-20 ratio. 80% of hedge fund returns is beta and 20% is alpha. Back then, people were saying, whoa, Lars, I think you're exaggerating. It seems to me today that I was really off back then, that today it's not 80, it's about 95%.
95%
of the average overall hedge fund performance is beta and not alpha. Then only 5% is alpha. The ratio in the equity markets is even less attractive. And I'm talking about, you know, that doesn't mean that, you know, the 5% real alpha, probably, let's give it 5 to 10% range of real alpha, is probably, you know, distributed quite unevenly across the hedge fund markets. There's a few managers that extract most alpha, and the wide majority of them is either very little alpha or many of them actually having negative alpha. And when I'm saying negative alpha, I mean, of course, after their fees. The alpha is much higher before the fees. So the alpha availability in the capital markets for hedge funds is there. It just gets very small or even negative when you apply all these hefty fees.
Lars, can you point us also to the real academic research that underpins your work? And I know you have been a prolific writer and book author, and you authored some studies and research papers yourself. Just can you give us a quick run through of what you have authored and what papers are specifically relevant to alternative beta?
Well, of course, the rules of modesty will prevent me from advocating my work too prominently here, but I published myself a book on the hedge fund return hypothesis back in 2004 with institutional investors, Your Money, called Through the Alpha Smokescreens, which takes on the hedge fund return hypothesis that a large majority of actually beta walks through all the academic references until that time, and actually provided a very nice idea of what the current status of the discussion was back in 2004. My work back then was also relating to earlier academics' works that we had seen coming from David Che and Bill Fung, from Tom Schneeweis, for example, that had already pointed in that direction. The first regression model applied to the returns of hedge funds was done by Bill Fung and David Che back in 1997. When they already said that majority of hedge fund returns is actually can be modeled quite well with a certain set of factors. Back first they started having 5, it became 8 later on. That pointed already in the right direction. I myself took up a research project in early 2005 where I came out with my own factor models. And they were not that dissimilar to anybody else's. So in other words, the originality of my work was quite limited in terms of the modeling. But there's one thing that I had applied to my 2005 paper, which was then published in the Journal of Alternative Investments, is that I started asking a question nobody else had asked before. The question was, can we take those linear factor models and turn them into trading models? In other words, can we just, from modeling, from quantifying, from analyzing risk premia, can we actually start replicating them? And as simple as the idea sounds, it was quite revolutionary. And my result back then was, yes, you can do that, however, with a very limited set of hedge fund strategies, which is basically the directional equity strategies, long short, event driven, short selling, that's about it. But the idea caught on. It only took a year and a half more, and Merrill Lynch and Goldman Sachs came out with their own linear factor models based on the research that we have provided. That was a starting point of linear factor models. If people read my paper very carefully, they will see that, you know, the applicability of these models is very limited to the linear factor models. Now, if you read Bill's and David's paper from 1997 very carefully, they already say that at the very end of their paper is that in order to properly model hedge funds, you would probably need to have nonlinear factors because the very linear nature of the linear factor models is very limited or is limiting the potential of hedge fund replication. Now, I came out with a book in, well, ironically, it was published in September 2008, just around the Lehman default. It's called Alternative Beta Strategies and Hedge Fund Replication, which provides you a full range of discussions about the different models and approaches. It was published with Wiley. And I think that still, I would believe, the state of the art of what the discussion is in the hedge fund replication space.
I would invest into your models, what types of risks do I take on? Or in other words, am I exposed now to the same risks as if I would be investing into a hedge fund?
Well, the fact that we extract the risk premium, the same risk premium as hedge funds do, actually is nothing else but stating the fact that we're exposing ourselves to the same systematic risks that hedge funds do. That's the very nature of risk premium, exposing ourselves to the systematic market risk. However, what you need to distinguish is that there in hedge fund investing, there are risks that are non-systematic. In other words, they're much more specific to the individual manager. They could be operation risk at the manager. They could be modeling risk. They could be fraud risk. They can be all different kinds of risks that people associate with hedge funds. Now, those are the risks that you would expose yourself to if you invest with individual hedge funds. On top of that, you would be exposed to the systematic risks that hedge funds have. We only take on the systematic risks. We're not exposed to the unsystematic risk of individual hedge fund managers. You can claim that, you know, and people investing with us would have the same risk on our side. We would impose idiosyncratic risk. That's only true in a very limited sense because we apply very generic models, very transparent models. We provide investors with the comfort of, you know, having the simplicity behind us, I would say. And there's no operational, no trading or execution risk that is nearly as high as in every hedge funds. The very fact that we run our strategies in a regulated format does not even make the possibility, or does not even make it possible that that there can be any fraud involved. Now, we're actually providing our products in a usage framework, by the way. So that's the distinction you have to make between systematic risk. Yes, they're the same as any hedge funds. That's why we make money. The unsystematic risk, the less comfortable risk, I would say, we don't have.
Some of your strategies also involve real research and hands-on security selection, or in your example of the merger arb situations, you really need to be on top of the current merger arb. What is the capability of your company, and how much money can you run with your alternative beta strategy?
A lot of investors ask us the capacity question, and the theoretical answer is capacity for beta is huge, almost limitless. However, there is, of course, what I call an operational capacity. And we try to actually, on a rolling forward basis, in terms of our operational setup, our infrastructure, to be ahead by about $2 to $3 billion capacity. At a given point in time, we can handle an extra $2 to $3 billion in capacity that we're running. We've proven that we're capable of doing that because we were running $1 billion+ in our portfolios over some periods of time without any to return impact, performance impact. No, that's the capacity. So theoretical capacity is extremely high. Operational capacity is limited in the sense that we need to have the trading execution, the modeling infrastructure, and all that in place in order to handle more money. But we've always been able to cope with that. And it's much easier to cope with that than versus the market capacity, which is not the problem in our case.